Hello, my name is Aaron Warnock, and I'm a math faculty advisor for Pearson. I'd like to share some strategies and practical tips on how you can use tagging in your MyLab courses in powerful and creative ways. Tagging is mostly an organizational tool for instructors to be able to create groups of students, groups of assignments, and then use those groupings to assign specific groups of content to specific groups of students. You can also use tagging to organize and collect gradebook data on specific groups of students as well. Important to know is that none of these tags display to the students in any way. This is purely an organizational tool for you, the instructor. To tag groups of students, that can be found on the gradebook page under More Tools and Student Tags. This particular course is a co-requisite course, so 23 of the 30 students are just taking Math 141, and 7 of the 30 students are taking both Math 141 and Math 108, a support course. So I've already added the tags, 108 students, 141 students, and then I can click on add here or the number of students and select the students who are in that group and put them in that group. And likewise with the 141, select the appropriate students and put them in that group. And then as you scroll down, you see which tag those students are in. You can also change and adjust those settings here. But I don't want to spend so much time talking about the settings, but the actual implementation. From the Assignment Manager, you can add tags to assignments under Manage and Add Tags. Very similarly, you can create the tags. In this case, I have Math 141, some study skills assignments, and then the support content, which is the Math 108. Add assignments to the groups here. Or you can scroll down and add them individually as well. But once we have those groups created, the most important piece is then how do we implement this? So I'm going to take a look at how would I assign the Math 108 content just to the Math 108 students. Under Manage, we're going to go to Adjust Student Settings. And then we're going to approach this from the assignment side. And this is my most favorite efficient way to do it. Under Assignment Tag, I'm going to go to the Support Content. And then I'm going to select Homework and select All, because there are a good 20 to 30 assignments that I'm dealing with here. So all of the support homework, and then I'm going to grab the 141 students. Let me explain why I've done it this way. I link my courses to Canvas. You may link to another LMS or Canvas. And I want all of these assignments to show up on Canvas so that the 108 students can see their support content on Canvas as well. So I have actually assigned all of the 108 content to all of the students at the moment. But now I come here and I grab the assignment tag support, and I grab all of the homeworks and then the 141 students, and I'm going to unassign it from the 141 students, and I'm going to remove the due date. Now this is important. The reason I remove the due date is when I go to manage and complete later, I don't want the students who don't have it assigned to them to be penalized for not having done it. So by unassigning and removing the due date, then all of those students will not see, the Math 141 students will no longer see the support content. I will hit Apply Settings, and now the 108 students see all of their support content and all of their 141 content, while the 141 students only see the 141 content. I also need to do this for quizzes now, so I'll switch to quizzes, select all, grab all the 141 students, and unassign all of that support content from the 141 students, and also remove the due date. Now when students look at their assignments, the 108 students will see these review assignments that came at the beginning of the term, but the 141 students will not see any of them. The first assignment they will see is this F1 and not the preparing for F1. They will see F2 and not the preparing for F2, but the 108 students see them all. Another great application I'd like to share with you is last fall when I taught two completely separate courses within one MyLab shell. They were both small courses. One had 9 students, one had 6. And I thought it'd be really nice to just have one shell that I was running both courses out of, but the students would only see the content that they needed to cover. You'll notice here that the whole first half of my assignment list is Math 81. Scrolling down Math 81, there's a few other tags in here as well. You can have more than one tag for things. And then down at the bottom of the list is all the Math 91 content. So I was able to create two completely mutually exclusive groups, Math 81 assignments, Math 91 assignments. And then I also did Math 81 students, Math 91 students. Doing the same thing, going into Adjust Student Settings, I was able to pull up the assignment list and say, all right, I want all the Math 81 content, and I'm going to select homework, select all, and we're going to unassign it from all the Math 91 students. So all of the 81 content, I'm unassigning from Math 91, and I'm giving a due date of blank, and I apply that. None of the 91 students see any of the 81 content. Then when I'm done with that, I come and I switch it to 91. And I select all the homework. And then I select all the 81 students. And I completely unassign all of the 81 content from the 91 students. This worked like a charm. And because they had no due date for the things that were unassigned to them, when I managed incompletes, they got no zeros. I exported all the grades into my Canvas gradebook. The other half of content that the students were not assigned was just blank, not zeros. So it actually worked beautifully. They had a lot of empty assignments, not zeros, and their score was accurate. So it worked better than I could have hoped. Another great use for tagging is working with students who need extra time on their quizzes or exams. This will be especially helpful for larger sections where you might have 10 or more students who need such a setting. Under tags here, you can see that I have a 30-minute quiz or a 40-minute quiz tag. For the greatest efficiency, you will want to organize quizzes by how long they are, and I'll show you why. If I select the 30-minute quizzes tag, and then we're looking at quizzes, and I want to select all of them, I can select my student tag, which is double time, or if you have a time and a half tag, you could do that as well. And then I will come down, and the time limit, I can check the class assignment settings here. The class assignment settings is 30 minutes. I can check the time limit and change that time limit to 60 minutes because they are double time. If I had a 1.5 time student tag, I could change this to 45 minutes. And it will apply to all of those students at once, and definitely want to show the time remaining. And I'll hit apply settings. If you just do one quiz at a time, then you'll have to go through and change each of the values. And if some quizzes are 30 minutes and some quizzes are 40 minutes, you will have to individually change those. So that's why we recommend when using tagging that you group them by 30 and 40 minute quizzes. Another example I have from this term is an instructor who wanted to give multiple versions of tests to his students in the same class. So you could create group A, group B, group C, and then create exams A, B, and C. And then you could assign A, B, and C to all students, and then unassign exams B and C to the group A, unassign exams A and C to group B, unassign exams A and B to group C. You get the idea. I wanted to share some other ways that you can creatively implement tagging. In our intermediate algebra course, there are two topics that we want students to show that they've mastered. Those are functions and lines. So after the first test, if the students did not pass the mastery on functions, I have a batch of assignments that the students can work on to review and then retake. And I can assign those only to the students who needed to pass Mastery 1 still. And same thing with Mastery on Lines. I can just assign it to that group of students who need it. Beyond just assigning to groups of students, the exam prep quizzes. I have 4 exam prep quizzes before each exam throughout the term. And then right before the final, I turn those all back on again. So because I created this exam prep quiz tag, when I am dealing with due dates for assignments, I can actually just pull up that tag. So instead of having to scroll through and find them all again under edit dates and assign status, here I now have tags available to me. So I can say, hey, I just want to look at my exam prep quizzes. And there's my 4 exam prep quizzes. I can select them all and say, let's bump that due date. This was a winter term, so you'll notice that I have bumped that due date back to March 23rd, even though they were previously due earlier in the quarter. So again, organization for myself, being able to pull them exactly what I want and not have to search. All throughout the system, you'll see a place where you can filter to tags and use exactly the tags you want. Relevant applications, I have different settings for those. I do accept them late, up to 24 hours. Without a penalty, homework gets a penalty right away, even though these are programmed as homework. So I create a separate tag and I'm able to apply those settings to that tag all at once. Same thing with optional pre-quizzes. I put an optional pre-quiz tag in here. Those don't count towards their grade, so I'm able to quickly grab all the optional pre-quizzes and omit those scores. Let me show that to you. Back on the gradebook, I can click on change weights. And then down here, I have the option to select tags. So I'm going to grab all of the optional pre-quiz tags. And from there, I can then check omit results, and you'll notice they're already checked. But I was able to do that all at once using tags and not having to individually omit them. Lastly, from the gradebook page, if you're going to export data, you can also export data based on tags. If I go to quizzes or tests, I can just export data with the mastery functions tag. If that's the information that I want to review, I can select that tag and just export that. This would also be a way at the end of the term, if you have a support course that you need a separate grade for, I could export all of the support assignments, which I plan to do in my 108-141 course, and then just have the grades for Math 108 in an Excel spreadsheet to submit, while the main Math 141 grade is calculated in MyLab. You can get creative with your tags. If you need to give an athlete report for your athletes every few weeks, you could create an athlete tag, put those athletes in that group, and then whenever that report is due, export the grades just for those athletes. If you want to know how do your commuters do compared to how your on-campus students do, create a commuters tag and an on-campus tag, and then you could do separate grade exports for each of those groups and see how they're faring. The sky is the limit on the way you can creatively use tagging to collect data about your students, to organize how you're assigning content to your students. Thank you for watching and happy tagging!